that's another story.
Good morning, Marty McNeeley for WGN News 9. On the beat of this hour, here's what's happening. Two major fires in the news, one in Louisiana and the other in suburban Bensenville. Illinois ranks 7th on the nation's average income list. Mayor Bolandic finally agrees to enter the strike by the city college teachers. And the Cubs outfumble the Pirates and lose a 14-inning marathon to the Bucks. We'll have all the details and highlights coming up on the beat in a couple of minutes. Please stay with us.
Bounce has a new, longer-lasting, fresh smell. It makes clothes smell fresh even longer, and women just love it. My wife dried this jacket with new Bounce a week ago. I put it on this morning, and it still smells fresh.
I dried this dress with new Bounce days ago, and it still smells fresh.
And with Bounce, clothes come out nice and soft.
They sure do. My dress is really soft.
I use new Bounce on Jimmy's shirt Thursday, and it still smells fresh.
And with Bounce, synthetics don't cling. See? My socks don't cling to my pants.
Mine don't either.
I dried my blouse with new Bounce last week, and it still smells fresh.
And Bounce is so easy to use. Simply tear off a sheet, throw it in the dryer, you're done. As your clothes are tumbling, Bounce is working in the heat of the dryer, so clothes will smell fresh even longer. The fresh smell of new Bounce stays with your clothes longer. But boxes of new Bounce don't stay in the store long. I better get some more.
New Bounce. It makes clothes smell fresh even longer. Your family will just love it.
Yoplait yogurt, smooth and natural. Yoplait yogurt, it feels so good to eat.
Yoplait yogurt, there's a creamy difference in Yoplait yogurt. It feels so good to eat.
The fruit is real.
It's a taste you can feel.
Feels so good to eat.
Yoplait.
Here are the current readings under partly sunny skies, barometer 30.1.
When you're out fishing, you count on your radio. So use the batteries you can count on too, Duracell.
Tests show that after regular carbon batteries wear out, Duracell keeps going strong. Because Duracell batteries last longer.
And that means a lot, whenever you use your radio.
Duracell. The copper top battery. No regular battery looks like it.
Or lasts like it.
The best darn burger in the whole wide world. Hit it, kids.
Burger King.
Who's got the best darn burger in the whole wide world? Guys?
Burger King and I.
Who's looking pretty sharp now?
Who's shining up the floor? Who's slicing fresh tomatoes? Who tries to give you more? Let's open up the door. Who's got the juicy flame broiled burger that's never, never fried? Who's got Coke and crispy French fries? It's Burger King and I.
Burger King and I.
Who's got the best darn burger in the whole wide world? Who's got the best darn burger in the whole wide world? Burger King and I.
We hope you've enjoyed tonight's feature, Irma La Douce. Tomorrow night at 11, WGN Television presents David Jansen and Barbara Rush in the horror thriller, Moon of the Wolf. Plan to be with us for all the outstanding features when WGN Television presents the finest films in Chicago nightly at 10:30.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Pia Zadora.
Love is made for lingering, and that's what lovers do. Over stolen kisses, candlelight, and Dubonnet for two.
Next time, Dubonnet, red or blonde, the French idea of a cocktail.
Dubonnet for two.
Parlez-vous, Dubonnet?
The French idea of a cocktail since 1846.
Olympia Dodge, serving all of Southwest Chicagoland from Chicago Heights. Olympia Dodge has over 200 vans and pickup trucks in stock. Olympia Dodge, where you can buy a new 78 van with full factory equipment for only $40.95, stock number 87029. Or buy a new 78 pickup with full factory equipment for a mere $38.95, stock number 88049. Olympia, the dealingest Dodge dealer in Chicagoland, and now's the time to deal. Route 30 at Western, Chicago Heights, the big name, Olympia Dodge.
Light and lively, the difference is that you help yourself to flavor with half the fat.
Kraft announces Light and Lively processed cheese product in slices and a loaf.
Help yourself.
Half the fat of regular American processed cheese and lower calories for all your favorite recipes.
Try Light and Lively, the difference is that you help yourself to flavor with half the fat. And America spells cheese. K-R-A-F-T.
Keep tabs on your health. Call your doctor or the nonprofit Cancer Prevention Center at 440-7110 for an overall physical examination. This is WGN-TV Chicago Television 9.
Good morning. On the beat, here's what's been happening. A spectacular fire raged for hours Thursday in suburban Bensenville near O'Hare Airport. Muriel Clair reports.
The fire at the Montgomery Ward warehouse in Bensenville broke out shortly after noon, forcing the evacuation of some 200 employees. No injuries were reported.
There was a red alert in the chute bowl, and then there was a blue alert, and that means to evacuate the building. So we grabbed our purses and our coats. We work in the office up on the second floor, and we start walking down and telling everybody else to evacuate the building. But we didn't realize that this is what was going to happen.
Was it a lot of panic, a lot of screaming?
No, nothing. Everybody was took their time, and nobody got excited because we didn't think it was that bad.
Firemen from at least a half dozen communities battled the four-alarm blaze for several hours. The entire center portion of the building was gutted. The two end wings were water and smoke damaged. The building was a storage place for a variety of merchandise, including ammunition. Several explosions rang out during the fire. Officials at the scene attributed them to the ammunition reacting to the heat. Muriel Clair, News 9.
A fire and explosion at a federal oil reserve in an isolated swamp area of southwestern Louisiana is producing a 200-foot pillar of flame. Here's a report from Joe Giardina of WDSU Channel 6 New Orleans.
The fire is burning out of control in a series of caverns in the small southwest Louisiana community of Hackberry. It broke out this afternoon when an explosion ripped through a well which was being used to fill the caverns with crude oil shipped in from the Persian Gulf. Two men were severely burned and were rushed to a special burn unit in Baton Rouge. According to authorities, all they could do right now is sit back and watch the flames.
As far as we know, they're just waiting for some additional equipment. Right now, they were trying to cool it. The well's the site now, so they could approach it. But other than that, really nothing has been happening.
In other words, the fire is so intense that they can't even get near it.
That's correct.
Oil well troubleshooters have been summoned to try to blow out the towering flames roaring more than 200 feet in the air. Each cavern is about the size of a 10-story building and is able to hold more than 10 million barrels of oil. The storage facility was put into operation earlier this year. Federal authorities described the facility as extremely safe. Joe Giardina, News Center 6.
The challenge, to clean lots of really dirty clothes. The prize, a year's supply of free detergent. Which detergent would you use?
You chose Tide. Why?
I just like Tide, and that's all I use.
That's my last box of Tide. Why don't I give you this?
I'd rather use Tide.
Come on, Ginny. What's the difference?
No, it's awesome theory. This is my thing.
We're going to wash with Tide,
It says it all. Look at it.
The dirt was all over the place.
Now,
I have a very clean shirt.
When you need to count on cleaning, you can put your trust in Tide.
Beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
Not you, Rosie. Your fancy new towels.
Oh, great looking, huh? They're new designer towels that work as well as Bounty.
That is Bounty.
That's right, the quicker picker-upper. Now in designer patterns, too. Feast your eyes. Four terrific designs and three bright new colors.
Very nice. They're all great looking.
Of course, new designer towels from Bounty. The quicker picker-upper.
Three generations of Shutans have served Chicagoland photography enthusiasts since 1918. Visit Shutan Camera Company, 153 West Wacker Drive at LaSalle Street, Chicago.
Secretary of State Vance is in Saudi Arabia trying to win support for the Camp David Accords. Earlier, Vance failed to get a quick endorsement from Jordan's King Hussein, although Hussein did promise not to close the door on the peace initiative. Vance's mission will take him to Syria on Saturday. Meanwhile, former Secretary of State Henry Kissinger has chided President Carter for becoming directly involved in peace negotiations between Egypt and Israel. Kissinger says, quote, "It's too risky. If something goes wrong, you have nothing to fall back on." Officials in Iran now say at least 25,000 people died in last Saturday's earthquake. Only 1,800 residents of Tabas survived the devastating quake. That's 1,800 survivors in a city with a population of about 17,000. The Republican National Committee's Tax Blitz Jet came to Chicago Thursday. That story from News 9's Larry Roderick.
The chartered 727 jetliner carried Republican congressional leaders on a cross-country sales pitch, the product here being a GOP attempt to beat the Democrats at the tax cut game. Governor Thompson, Senator Percy, Congressman Anderson, among the Illinois contingent who will get heavyweight backing for an 18-hour blitz in the Chicago area. Cutting through all the rhetoric, what these men will be telling reporters and luncheon audiences is, send more Republicans to Congress, but whichever way you vote, tell your congressman you want the Kemp-Roth tax cut bill approved.
Our proposal is to cut taxes by 10% a year for each of the next 3 years, a 33% cut in taxes for every family. Nobody's left out. Everybody in America gets an across-the-board tax reduction of at least one-third of the taxes they're now paying. People in Chicago are paying $800 a year per family, more taxes for income taxes than they paid 4 years ago. I just don't think people can afford that. We are committing as a party to an across-the-board tax cut for everybody.
The group was to be joined later by former California Governor Ronald Reagan and New York Congressman Jack Kemp, co-author of the Republicans' major tax cut legislation. Friday was to be Media Blitz Day, highlighted by a noontime rally on the plaza just south of the Chicago Tribune. This is Larry Roderick reporting.
More testimony Thursday at the House Assassinations Committee investigation into the murder of John F. Kennedy. Former President Ford and two other surviving members of the Warren Commission appeared before that committee. Ford stood by the original findings of the commission that Lee Harvey Oswald acted alone. The House approved a federal budget for next year, which trims more than $20 billion from the deficit President Carter originally projected. And it makes room for an income tax cut, $2 billion more than the one recently approved by the House. Final Senate approval is expected on Monday. The average income of each of the 216 million persons who lived in the United States last year was $7,019, an increase of 9.6% over 1976. Alaska led the nation with an average income of $10,586 per person. At the bottom of the list, Mississippi, whose residents earned an average of $5,030. Illinois ranks seventh with an average income of $7,768, some $700 over the national average.
Sondag Datsun in Park Ridge has hundreds of brand new Datsuns. So many cars that Sondag is known as the Datsun supermarket in the Midwest. With cars like these money-saving B210s at supermarket prices you'll love. Their Datsun B210s start at $33.94. Sondag Datsun in Park Ridge, the Midwest supermarket Datsun store. 740 Bussey Highway in Park Ridge, 5 minutes from the Kennedy or I-294.
The $169 challenge. Lincoln challenges the entire carpeting industry to beat this staggering offer. Yes, you can buy carpeting for three full rooms, 34 square yards, excluding padding and installation, for only $169. Not just ordinary carpeting, but this dramatically carved sculptured carpeting. Choose from 16 decorator-inspired colors, exciting solids to harmonize with your interior, colorful tweeds to mix or match as you please. It's the great $169 challenge. Because Lincoln is not a retail store with costly overheads, our direct volume sales bring you great values like this. Three rooms of elegantly carved sculptured carpeting, yours for less than $10 a month. Lincoln comes to you with large samples and no obligation. Don't wait. Call National 29000 now. Suburbs call Lincoln Collect. National 29000. National 29000.
A cement shortage is having an adverse effect on construction in the Chicago area. Muriel Clair reports from Des Plaines.
Contractors used to order concrete from the Meyer Material Company in the morning and have it delivered in the afternoon, but not anymore. The cement shortage that started in the western states now is being felt in the Chicago area. Officials of the Meyer Material Company, one of the major suppliers of concrete in this area, say they can no longer accept orders for same-day delivery, nor can they take orders too far in advance.
The demands that are being placed upon us are such that we cannot fulfill them based on the amount of cement that we are able to obtain today.
Do you foresee any let-up? I mean, has there been any indication from people who supply cement to you?
Frankly, we don't see any relief in the problem until this winter or till the end of the building or construction season, which for all practical purposes is the 1st of December or depending on how cold the winter gets.
The cement shortage began last year in California. An unusually long building season there did not give cement manufacturers an opportunity to stockpile supplies. To further complicate things, the Environmental Protection Agency leaned on many cement manufacturers to meet agency standards. For some companies, this meant costly plant renovations or getting out of the business altogether. The problem worsened in the Chicago area when locks on the Illinois River were closed in early summer, halting the shipment of cement by boats from St. Louis to Illinois. Concrete industry spokesmen say there is no way of predicting the end of the shortage. Area builders are getting more than just a little anxious as they race against the start of cold weather. The holes for foundations have been dug, but delivery of concrete to pour in the holes has been slow and is getting slower. Municipalities also are feeling the pinch. Suburban Rolling Metals is experiencing an 8-week delay in completing a $179,000 curb and gutter repair job. Streets are torn up, giant slabs of sidewalk are missing, and some residents are very unhappy. The ripple effect of the shortage has already begun. Cement finishers who traditionally classify September as one of their better work months have been working only 3 days out of five. The Home Builders Association warns that no let-up in the shortage could mean more shortened work weeks or no work at all for building industry tradesmen. Muriel Clair, News 9.
A windfall from Washington on Thursday for the RTA, the CTA, and the City of Chicago. The Urban Mass Transit Administration has promised more than $137 million in federal grants. $44 million will go to the RTA for improvement of commuter rail programs, $25 million for construction of the CTA O'Hare Rapid Transit Extension, and $7 million to the city for construction of the State Street Mall. The Democratic candidate for governor, Michael Bacallus, has accused Governor Thompson of deliberately covering up possible criminal acts in connection with the Thompson tax lid proposition drive. Bacallus blasted Thompson for choosing Illinois Law Enforcement Director Tyrone Fawner to probe the allegations. He also compared it to Watergate.
If anybody has a special responsibility to come and say that I'm clean on this matter, he has that responsibility and he ought to do it and answer those questions totally and fully and to everybody's satisfaction. I mean, he's the one who rode to political office on the white horse in terms of being anti-corruption, being anti all the wrongdoing, in terms of being anti what all the politicians were. He was the anti-politician. He's turned out to be the politician's politician. I mean, He's the one who's offering jobs straight out, you know, for people. He's the one who's paying people, was paying people to collect signatures. He's the one who has fulfilled every stereotype of what the worst aspects of politics is all about. And so I think he has a special responsibility here. It's always the individuals who are the crusaders, I think, who fall the hardest. And he's falling pretty hard.
Mayor Bolandic has decided to intervene in the almost one-month-old Chicago City College teachers' strike. He's called in both sides for a meeting in his City Hall offices Friday morning at 10 o'clock. But the City College's board has a special meeting scheduled for 9 when it's expected to decide whether to cancel the fall semester as of Monday. Norman Swenson, president of the Cook County College Teachers Union, says he hopes the board will not act irrationally by canceling the fall semester. If it does, he says, the school system stands to lose $30 million from the state, and he can't imagine a willingness to let that happen. Swenson then turned his attention to the meeting with the mayor.
I want to emphasize, of course, that our meeting does not mean that we are going to make any kind of concession as far as our teaching load is concerned. The faculty will not agree to that. We rejected that before the strike began, and we will not agree to any kind of change of that sort that would undermine the quality of education in the city colleges.
And meanwhile, striking teachers in the far west suburban Marquardt School District 15 have been ordered to return to work Friday or face dismissal. In Highland Park, federally mediated talks were held Thursday night to try and settle a four-day-old strike by teachers in School District 108, which is keeping more than 2,700 students out of classes. A new leader has taken over at the Metropolitan Sanitary District, as Don Harris reports.
The troubled sanitary district Thursday experienced one of those meetings that critics described as only in Chicago. Bart Lynam resigned as general superintendent, effective October 1st, and Deputy Chief Engineer Hugh McMillan was elected to replace him in the job, again only in Chicago, that pays $63,745.50. First, Lyman refused to reconsider his resignation. Then the board rejected Commissioner Joanne Alter's motion for a blue ribbon search committee. Then McMillan was elected. And finally, Bart Lynam consented to being hired as a consultant for the sanitary district between October 1st and December 31st at a salary of $22,800 a year. And in case you're curious, the news release announcing Lynam's resignation and McMillan's election, that news release was prepared on Wednesday. For News 9, this is Don Harris.
Olympia Dodge, serving all of Southwest Chicagoland from Chicago Heights. Olympia Dodge, where you can buy a new 78 Aspen coupe with full factory equipment for only $36.95, stock number 82105. Or buy a new 78 Aspen wagon with full factory equipment for a mere $39.95, stock number 82113. Olympia, the dealingest Dodge dealer in Chicagoland, and now's the time to deal. Route 30 at Western, Chicago Heights. The big name, Olympia Dodge.
The challenge, to clean lots of really dirty clothes. The prize, a year's supply of free detergent. Which detergent would you use?
You chose Tide. Why?
But I'm not going to take any chances.
That happens to be my last box of Tide. Why don't I just give you this?
No.
Give you this one.
No.
What about a liquid?
I really don't want a liquid.
Let's wash with Tide.
Well, you see, it came clean. They were a mess.
Yes.
And now they're clean.
When you need to count on cleaning, you can put your trust in Tide.
Sport Mart, fantastic selection of latest colors and styles in Speedo racing suits. All sizes available, male and female. Four Chicagoland Sport Marts. For sports, it's Sport Mart.
The issue of the dispute between the firemen's union and the city is not a question of whether the firemen will go on strike. The basic issue is the refusal of the city to accept the union as bargaining agent for the firemen. It is possible that the continued refusal of the city to recognize the union might precipitate some kind of work stoppage by the firemen. The firemen may decide that a strike or threat of a strike is the only pressure that they can apply by way of getting the city to bargain with their union. The mayor himself is opposed to the idea of negotiating with the firemen's union. He wants to preserve the present system for arriving at a deal with the firemen. The system that he talks about consists of his telling the firemen what they can have, sealing the deal by shaking hands with somebody. This is the same system that City Hall employs in dealing with the Chicago policemen. Nobody is allowed to bargain for the firemen and policemen. There is no negotiating. There are various things that the firemen's union say might like to discuss: the work schedule, the number of men who must be on every piece of apparatus, quality control of the equipment that the city provides, but nothing pertaining to the city's deal with the firemen is negotiable. Not a thing. Nothing is going to change until the city is willing to accept their union as the valid bargaining agent of these firemen. The Chicago firemen are really a captive workforce with no bargaining position. City Hall wants to keep it that way. This is the heart of the dispute. The possibility of a strike is merely the byproduct of a battle for union recognition, and I am Len O'Connor.
The result of a lot of bright ideas are now on display in Chicago, as Joanne Williams reports.
On display now at the Museum of Science and Industry are what Industrial Research Development magazine calls 100 of the most significant technological and scientific inventions of 1977. For instance, the voice output solar energy reporter. It monitors the intensity of the sun during the day and relays that information by phone through a non-human sounding synthesized voice. It can show how much solar energy you could be using during a day in your solar heating system. Or the TCM oxygen monitor. It's designed to monitor the oxygen in the blood of babies without having to repeatedly take samples. Eventually, it may be able to monitor the amount of oxygen in the blood of babies during birth. And the dual detector cardiac probe. It can monitor the action of the heart's left ventricle faster than current methods and stores the information on audio tape. And in their fields of use, some of these inventions may become as well known as Polaroid's instant color film and the flash cube. Those are past winners of the IR 100 award. For News 9, Joanne Williams at the Museum of Science and Industry.
Here are this week's winning numbers in the Illinois State Lottery in the 50-cent big payday game. The $25 winner is 668, and the $5 winner is 68. The $50,000 qualifying number is 2. The $150 millionaire number, 0691. In the $1 touchdown game, the winning numbers are 45, 46, 39, and 20. The $5 city of the week is Chicago.
Sharon, a freshman, just taught me a thing or two about laundry. She said, Professor, if your powder needs help, like spray for hamburger grease and liquid for collars, why use it? Era does it all by itself. Era combines ingredients like these, so it gets your whole wash really clean.
Clean?
Clean. Remarkable. Era really does it, all by itself. A plus.
Era does it. Meow, meow, meow. All by itself.
Why is hero Burt Reynolds in love but scared to marry? Find out in this week's Star. When and why did Jackie O take shock therapy? Find out in this week's Star. Could Jimmy Carter's little raft ride cost more than $1 million? Find out in the Star. What's inside Galactica's rocket ship? TV's space sex symbol, Dirk Benedict.
Want to know how I lost exactly 14 pounds in exactly 14 days? The Scarsdale diet. The diet that made restaurants change their menus.
Find out all this in this week's Star.
Hey, Rosie.
Yeah?
The diner looks terrific.
New curtains, new flowers,
oh.
New towels.
New towels?
Rosie, where's the bounty?
In your hand, Alice. Now the quicker picker-upper comes in designer patterns, too.
Designer bounty?
Terrific. Feast your eyes. Four terrific designs in three bright new colors. They look great.
Just what my kitchen needs.
They're new designer towels from Bounty, the quicker picker-upper.
Well, the Pirates needed 14 innings to beat the Cubs 3-2 at Wrigley Field. The Cubs used 27 players to no avail. They trailed 2-1 when Mike Vail batted with two men on in the ninth inning.
There's a ground ball, and Tavares over to second for one. Here's the relay, and it's a wild heave, and the tying run is going to score. Jerry White scores, and the Cubs are back in this ballgame.
There was a frightening moment when Gene Kleins batted in the 12th inning.
Shakes one off. Here we go. There's a smash. Ooh, man, that hit him. I think he caught the ball, but he is lucky to be alive. That smash went back to Whitson. Apparently, it stuck in his glove, and it took him to the ground with it, and I've never seen a pitcher hit harder by a line drive in my life. Watch this. Whitson is still not up. He's on his knees. Here it is. In the glove. Caught it in self-defense. Down he goes. He landed on his back and hurt himself, it looks like. Boy, what a smash. What a smash. He's okay. He's on his feet. He's walking off under his own power.
In the 14th inning, ex-Cub Matt Alexander won it for the Pirates.
There he goes. Here's that throw to second. He is safe. As a matter of fact, the ball goes into center field, and Alexander races to third, and he's safe. And look out, he's going to race for the plate as the ball gets away at third, and the Pirates have a run. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Oh, yes, Jack. Suter, the loser, despite a 16-hit attack by the Cubs, who play at St. Louis on Friday night. Our telecast begins at 7:30. The White Sox had the day off. They open a homestand on Friday night at Comiskey Park against the California Angels. Checking other scores now, Kansas City beat Milwaukee 8-4, Texas over Minnesota 6-3. The Yankees remained a couple of games ahead of Boston by beating Toronto 7-1. The Red Sox down Detroit 5-1. Tiger manager Ralph Houk announced his retirement. Les Moss, the former Sox catcher and coach, will take over the Tigers next season. Pittsburgh picked up a half game on the Phillies, who were rained out of Montreal. The Phillies now lead the Pirates by a game and a half. St. Louis beat the Mets 6-2. Houston shut out Atlanta 2-0. And San Francisco lost to San Diego 5-1. Lightly regarded Happy Escort won the first and fourth heats to capture the little brown jug for three-year-old pacers at Delaware, Ohio. Racetrack veterinarian Mark Girard has been convicted of a minor charge in last year's horse-switching scandal at Belmont Park, but has been acquitted on more serious charges.
Chicago's famous water tower in the heart of the new downtown. It's where the action is. Welcome to Tower Oldsmobile, located in the new downtown, and we have the action you're looking for, like your choice of prestige-built Toronados. Cut loose in a Tower Olds Cutlass for $44.50, and shop Tower's large indoor selection of recent trade-ins. Save time, save money. Buy where the action is. Tower Oldsmobile in the new downtown. Only minutes from major expressways and miles ahead of any competition.
Now Chicago's weather forecast for the rest of the night, partly cloudy and cooler, with a low ranging from near 60 along the lake to the mid-40s in the outlying areas. Friday, mostly sunny and cool with a low in the mid or the upper 60s. Friday night, fair and cool, low in the lower 50s. And Saturday, sunny, pleasant, high in the low or the mid-70s. Winds will be out of the north, 5 to 10 miles an hour, becoming variable late tonight. East to northeast, 6 to 12 miles an hour Friday. Right now, it's a cool 53 degrees at Midway. That's 12 Celsius, 51 degrees at O'Hare, 63 degrees along Chicago's lakefront. The relative humidity, 90%. The wind is out of the west at 6 miles an hour. And Jerry Golden will report on Newsbreak later. I'm Marty McNeeley for WGN News 9. Thank you for watching. Have a good day tomorrow.
Following is an editorial setting forth the views of WGN Continental Broadcasting Company. Speaking for the station, Mary D.
A majority of the members of the Chicago City Council have co-sponsored an ordinance to create an elected school board. This would be no improvement for Chicago, nor would it provide what sponsors want, a school board which is more responsive and more accountable to the people. First, the proposed districts would be composed of about 200,000 persons, each bigger than any school district in the state. Second, the proposed salary of $15,000 a year will attract only party hacks whose attitude will be getting a job which won't strain them. Third, all terms on the proposed elected board would end at the same time. While many members might be re-elected, we will not have the assured continuity of the present staggered terms. Fourth, if accountability and a high caliber of membership truly is desired, another ordinance will provide both. That is an ordinance to formalize the Mayor's Advisory Commission on School Board Nominations, forcing the mayor to appoint board members from among those recommended by the commission. A few months ago, with three posts to fill, the mayor selected only one person on the commission's list, a holdover, while reappointing two other members despite their rejection by the commission. Chicagoans will be deluded greatly if they think electing school board members will change anything. Forcing the mayor to appoint on merit, however, just might.
The preceding editorial presents the views of WGN Continental Broadcasting Company. In keeping with our policy of fairness, we will provide an opportunity for reply to qualified persons or organizations having opposing views. Copies of this editorial available on written request.
Ready, Slugger?
Ready, Daddy.
Hit it, Slugger!
Arthur couldn't wait to buy Kevin that baseball outfit.
But will he notice how nice I got it?
With Downey?
Will he notice the softness?
Or how Downey helps rinse out static cling? Still, Downey's April fresh smell. He ought to notice that.
Honey, what'd you do to Slugger's shirt? It smells...
April fresh?
Yeah.
You noticed. Hey, I made a hit.
The April fresh smell of Downey.
Beautiful apartment. Beautiful cold, like the red nose.
That's no way to treat a sore nose.
Posh puffs. Stunning.
And puffs feel softer, less irritating.
Tissues are tissues.
Close your eyes. Hands out.
Oh, come on.
Rub each one on your nose.
This one's softer. Puffs.
Soft and beautiful.
Puffs, the softest way to treat a sore nose.
This is WGN-TV Chicago Television 9.
And now, dim the lights, bolt the doors, but don't be frightened. That will come later here on Creature Feature. Tonight, a mad doctor mixes the blood of an ape with the blood of a human. The result is deadly terror for a beautiful girl. Bela Lugosi horrifies you in Murders in the Rue Morgue. Here in just one moment.
It's happening. Yes, a furniture happening. It's Nelson Brothers Furniture, Bedding, and Appliances Price Slashing Happy Day Sale. 10 happy saving days for you. Hundreds of items. Savings in most every department. Happy Day Sale prices on brilliant living room ensembles, luxurious bedroom groups, dining room and dinettes. Happy Day Sale prices on famous brand refrigerators, ranges, washers, dryers, television and stereos, mattresses, sleeper sofas, Hollywood and bunk beds. Hundreds of bargains. Savings in most every department. Use your credit power at Nelson Brothers and get in on the Happy Day sales saving.